Frugal partner. When I, 22F, started a relationship with my boyfriend, 24M, 3 years ago, I knew he was very particular about money. We would split everything 50-50, but he also counted every little thing, like parking or tips, and insist on splitting everything to the penny. It worked for a while, now we moved in about a year ago. It needs saying that we're both in amazing jobs with high salaries, but he earns more than twice what I earn. So with that in mind, we were still splitting all expenses 50-50, and again, despite the vast salary difference, I was okay with that. Recently we went out and he treated me to a meal, unusual for him, but happened a couple of times during our relationship. I was very thankful and pleasantly surprised. However, during the date night he was somewhat disrespectful and rude towards me, and said something that upset me. I decided it wasn't worth bringing this up during date night not to ruin it and played it nice. However, it stuck with me, and the next day we had an argument. I said how it was rude of him to say what he said that night, and that it somewhat spoiled my experience of the date night, when he goes, "Well, I think we had a great night which I paid for." It was very humiliating that he brought this nice gesture up to tell me I must have had a good time because he chivalrously treated me to it. Later we talked calmly and agreed that we were both wrong I to start the argument, he to hold the paid bill over my head. And then he goes, "Actually, I'm much better with the frugality issue right now. You use more electricity and water between us two, you prefer buying more expensive groceries, but I still agree to pay 50-50. This struck me again. It turns out he is calculating everything I spend, holds it in his head and feels like he is doing me a big favor just splitting stuff 50-50. I thought 50-50 was normal in a household. Seeing how neither of us is struggling financially, we're as far from it as possible, and we both use utilities and buy food, I do not see a valid reason for such scrupulous counting of who spends what. It upset me deeply that he is not capable of seeing the relationship as a shared experience and therefore shared expense. When we just moved in, he insisted we live outside of London close to his office, so I paid £330 every month, prior to COVID, now we both WFH, to cover my train commute. I didn't ask him to split it despite the fact that I would not be paying it if we agreed to live midway between our offices. Right now, I have chronic gastritis, stomach illness, and have to be very particular about groceries, as eating most foods causes me pain. Choosing foods that I'm allowed in order to maintain the variety of my diet, white fish, seafood, certain fruit, etc., might have increased my contribution to our grocery bill to some extent. But counting how much electricity and water we use, is it overboard, or am I just being dramatic? Is it often that partners regularly mention your expenses in that manner, seeing how they earn twice as much, and have almost five times as much in savings, while none of us struggles with money? I feel humiliated by such attitude. You spend this much more here and there, but I am amazing enough to split it, and I don't know how to approach this situation. Any opinions or advice? He sounds fucking exhausting. He convinced you that bringing up what upset you means you're to blame. That's manipulative and I don't typically use that word. He also agreed he was wrong to hold the bill over your head but clearly still does, always has, and frankly always will. This amount of stress you're being put under over money, the disrespect, it's actually disgusting. Does he build up your confidence in yourself at all? Does he make you feel like a better, stronger person? Or is he making you feel like a burden? I would start thinking about how much his attitude is hurting you and ask yourself if it's worth it. You use more electricity and water between us two. Wow, there's a difference between frugality of living and parsimony of spirit. This guy sees the price of everything and the value of nothing. He is ungenerous in spirit. He was rude on a date and held it over your head that he paid for everything. He likes to wield the power of money, and this is not a good sign. You have a chronic illness and he is counting to the nearest penny how much you spend on food? How rude and unkind and unloving. Honestly, please look deeply at this relationship, it sounds tiring. I guess this might translate to being ungenerous in other ways. Is he considerate of your pleasure and attentive to your needs? I'm sorry, but your boyfriend sounds absolutely awful. It's literally psychotic for him to be counting every single thing you use. Sorry to break it to you, but he clearly isn't in love with you if he has to bring these things up often. Perhaps you aren't used to a normal, nice relationship? I'd never dream of mentioning half the things he has, and I'd never dream of going 50-50 on everything. It's only fair that if he has a higher wage, he should contribute a little more. It's extremely strange as he is only 2 years older than me and is acting like a middle-aged man already. If he's like this now, what do you think he'll be like a couple years down the road? Much, much worse. Go somewhere you are appreciated and good luck. Your partner is stingy to the point he cares about every penny more than he cares about making you feel loved. Were you putting a blind eye on this for years, even as you guys were moving in together? There is no way you didn't see this behavior before. Lady, he is not your life partner or your rock. He is that wall you constantly slam against while walking on eggshells because of his behavior towards you. Do you have friends? Then look around you. Do you see any other guy or girl treating their partner like he treats you? You two are not a couple, just roommates with benefits. Nothing more. Hell, people treat their friends better than he treats you. Who is in a relationship with him? Open your eyes and start seeing what he is showing you. He sounds terrible. What happens if you get married? Will all expenses be shared then, or will he still expect a 50-50 split? Will he allow you to still make the same spending decisions if your finances are combined? I would worry that his manipulation of you through finances will only get worse if you combine and share expenses. He will clearly always be making these calculations and holding them over you. You use more electricity and water between us two. It sounds as though you're in the UK. Unless you're in a property with a water meter, the amount of water you use has no real impact on the water bill, unless you're filling a swimming pool in the back garden or running a hairdresser salon from the house. Similarly with electrics. Using the kettle is very high energy, but plugging in a device to charge up isn't. This is about power and control, not about the actual bill amount. Red flags everywhere. He paid for the date so he could have an excuse for why it was okay to hurt your feelings. Regardless of what he paid for that date, it wasn't okay. He sounds like a shitty person. Someone who loves you does not humiliate you or tell you how being in a relationship with you is a favor to you. He looks down on you. If the only way you can make this relationship work is to question the validity of your reasonable boundaries, is it really worth it? You are very young. Can you imagine living the rest of your life squabbling over pennies like this? What would happen if you married him, had a baby and your income went down during maternity leave? Or you had a period of sickness that prevented you from working? Can you imagine being financially dependent on him? Worse still, he has more disposable income than you, but he has created a situation where you are worse off because of your travel costs. My advice is to break up with him. Go and live in a house share with some friends and don't cohabit with a man for a good while yet. No, you're not being dramatic. It sounds so draining. I understand splitting bills, as that is what most working couples do. But not to the extent that you go through. You're only young, not in a disrespectful way. Do you think you can really put up with this for the next 60 years? My husband and I have been together for 30 years and he makes significantly more money than I. Not once, even while dating, has he ever held that over my head. Your boyfriend is not frugal, he's cheap and controlling. Being frugal is being careful where your money goes, being cheap is what your boyfriend does. You're young, so I would suggest finding someone who isn't so cheap, but more importantly, controlling. Good luck. Cheap. The word you're describing is cheap, not frugal. Right now, I have chronic gastritis. $50 says it's stress-related. This shit is going to kill you. 50-50 only works when the couple is making roughly the same amount. If there's a large difference, it makes more sense for the couple to contribute the same percentage of their paycheck. So if your shared expenses cost 40% of your combined income, you both contribute 40% of your income. It doesn't sound like he respects you though. I hope you feel better soon and find someone who isn't tyrant about money and doesn't want a parade when they do the bare minimum. Do you want to be in a transactional relationship? I don't understand why he insists on acting like you're both on minimum wage if neither of you are worried about money. There's frugal and there's just being tight, and this guy sounds like Ebenezer Scrooge. Neither my husband nor I have to worry about money. We both have great jobs and savings. This means that we hardly ever discuss money. It sounds as if you're in a similar situation, and yet he's counting every penny and being petty and mean about it. Can you really put up with this for the rest of your life? Because it's going to continue and it's going to get worse. You, no recognition 8037 said it better. 50-50 split is not unreasonable. Being frugal is not unreasonable. Your partner, however, is attempting financial abuse, is being several kinds of manipulative. So I suspect his parents were very overbearing. You know the type. Made him pay rent, said he owed them for birthing him. Something like that. In this instance, op, just have a sit-down talk with him. You're being reasonable and compromising, as any person in a relationship would be. He is not. I'm cheap, and I wouldn't be like this with a casual friend, let alone someone that I want to be in a bed with. My boyfriend is frugal, but he still takes me out to dinner or grabs takeaway, puts gas in my car, buys me things, listens to me when I say he needs something, etc. Yes, I send him money back a lot of the time the second he does something. He's only ever asked me to pay him back a couple of times. Split a hotel room. Him needing new boots for work. Should I have to or do I have to? No. Just like he shouldn't pay me back on weeks I spend money. Your boyfriend's reaction is shitty and mean. It won't get better with this guy. My friend was married to such a man for years. He would shovel his half of the driveway, buy only his own groceries and put them in his half of the refrigerator. When she had a serious health problem, he grudgingly agreed to pick up her prescriptions but only if she gave him the money prior. He thought it was nice that he didn't ask for gas money. When she was better, she finally left him. Don't let this be your future op. When men love someone, they are generous and love paying for a meal to impress you. He seems like his love for money overshadows his priorities. I would not stay in that relationship knowing I am being watched and judged based on my spending. It's clearly something he enjoys doing. He thinks he's doing you a favor by going 50-50 in everything. That is enough for me to leave. Think very carefully if you are happy to live in competition, who can be most frugal? Long term, would he help you pay if you got very sick? Would he tell you not to waste money going to doctors? Dental work? Would he hold all this money he has spent on you against you? Think things through. Being frugal is fine. Being precise is fine. Keeping score for the purpose of making you feel bad in an argument is not fine and where he crossed the line. Make it clear to him that it has to stop immediately. It is probably time to have a detailed discussion about finances to determine whether you and he are compatible long term. Do you really want to spend the rest of your life with someone so ungenerous? This nickel and diming is never a good sign in a relationship. Can you imagine yourself living this way for the rest of your life? What happens when you have kids and take mat leave, possibly making less money while you recover? This is only going to get worse. Read his statement about you using more electricity and more dollar in groceries, yet he still pays 50-50. Inform him an equitable division, based on your incomes, would he contributes two-thirds and you contribute one-third. I'd be willing to bet if you were earning the lion's share, he'd be expecting you to contribute more. He sucks. You should start spending a lot less money on combined stuff. If you'd combine income, and you would both pool it all, you'd both have equal say in any non-recurring expense. He is exploiting you financially, and the red flags about it are easy to spot. You're not an asshole for starting an argument, he's an asshole for assholish behavior. You called it out, and yes, you did that slightly unprofessional, but that's okay, as you're in a romantic relationship, and that stuff is personal. You are entitled to being upset when treated like a servant, because that is what he is doing. You agreed to live outside London near his shithole office? That was dumb. It sounds like you just let him walk all over you. You don't have to, you know. Not everyone jets their partner treat them like shit. This is very joy luck club. Let's put it bluntly, he cares more about money than about you. Why are you with someone who is so selfish he has to split everything to the penny? When you love and cherish someone, you don't worry about who paid more or less. You want to be generous with someone you love. And his attitude for treating you once in a blue moon is so condescending and smug, I'd never put up with it. Why would you want to spend your life with this selfish asshole? Y'all don't sound like a team. It sounds like his wallet versus your spending, even though you're not spending. There's a difference between being frugal and being a straight-up asshole. I'm frugal, I budget pretty hard and love a bargain, but this guy sound a lunatic. No wonder you've got stomach issues. This relationship sounds super stressful. Is this what you want for the rest of your life? Because he won't become less stingy with age. People generally don't. Info. How did your boyfriend grow up? Does he come from a poor background or was his family financially secure? Watching every variable household cost is a habit that is drilled into someone who grows up poor. I won't condemn him for being this way until I know the additional info with respect to this. That's massive red flag. I am okay with splitting everything, 50-50, and I do that myself with my boyfriend, but we don't live together, and when I have more money than him I will pay for meal and he will do the same thing. It's ridiculous to split everything in exactly 50-50 when you live together. No one should pay for everything, but it's okay that some month you pay more than him and other month he. I would understand this splitting everything thing if you don't have enough money, but you said that both of you have great salary, so I don't get why he's acting like that. In my opinion, he's weird and make you feel guilty for stupid things like I paid for dinner or you spend more water than I do. I would break up with him. He's not frugal, he's a mean-spirited, tight-arsed git. I couldn't stand anyone like this, and thankfully my hubby of 36 years is nothing like the tight wad that you're shacking up with. Heaven forbid that you marry him and become a som. He'll probably be the kind of guy who will demand the child allowance for nappies and formula. In my book, if he earns double, then he pays double. Your financial arrangements are extremely unfair to you, even if you're not too fussed about it. Why shouldn't you have the luxury of more savings? Please think about this very important issue. If he makes twice what you do, a 50-50 split isn't even fair, let alone his nitpicking. Yeah, that's a yikes from me. Fucking run. Do you want to live your life like this? This is about control. My boyfriend makes 6x my salary, a stipend because I'm in school. I personally like to split what I can in rent and food because it makes me comfortable. But he pays for everything else. Date nights once a week, gifts, travel, etc. The splitting stuff is not the issue to me. Even if your boyfriend makes more, it's the fact he feels like it gives him power to monitor your spending and take it out against you. Big red flag, and guarantee it'll spill into different areas of your relationship if it hasn't already. No empathy for your partner and the sacrifices she is making? Not a healthy relationship at all. He can't get past the money issue. I suggest y'all don't live together. Do you really want to spend the rest of your life with someone who will bitch every time, without missing, of taking you out on their tab? Even worse, do you really want to spend forever with somebody who will always find a way to blame you for their extremely frugal habits? Seriously, think about it. I hope you accept that's just the way he is and he'll never change, and that you move on and find happiness in someone else. There are several more issues here than his being frugal, and they're worse than simply being frugal. I honestly can't understand why you're with him. You have a high-paying job and he's an asshole, and that's about the nicest way of describing him, his behaviors and actions. He's rude, manipulative, abusive, and somehow you've chosen to be with him all this time. The best time to leave him was long ago. The next best time to leave him is today. As others have pointed out, he sounds exhausting to be around, and I'm sorry you're in this frustrating situation. Your boyfriend seems to have a very unhealthy relationship with money. I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt because I grew up low income and have had to unlearn a lot of ingrained habits and behaviors once I became financially independent, stable. His behavior seems more than typical frugality, it is borderline obsessive. Aside from being unfair to you, he should change for his own sake, because being this controlling about your finances does not seem healthy. I think it's a bad sign he is keeping score. Have you discussed what the future looks like with Cummingling funds? I'm all for a frugal lifestyle, but there is a certain point where you can't take it with you. If you and your boyfriend have differing views, this is something to discuss now before any more steps are taken. I hesitate to share my experience of sharing funds with my husband because ours were run-of-the-mill growing pains. I cannot say the same for your situation based on the facts above. What are you gaining from this relationship, other than stress that likely is resulting in stomach problems? Trust me, when I was in a bad relationship that manifested in physical symptoms, reflux, in my case, that went away as soon as the relationship was over. I would have lasted one date with this guy. Frugality is fine. Nickel and diming anyone, but especially your significant other, is so petty and graceless. I went through your profile and it seems you've had problems with his attitude for a long time. Why keep the relationship going? There are many red flags in the things you are describing. It's better to be alone than to be in bad company. I personally would never, never be in a relationship with a person like this. It feels uncaring, callous, and transactional. Since you're not married, you should consider moving out and suggesting he get therapy. Him calculating everything like this is unhealthy. It points to a really deep insecurity. This is basically keeping score, and you are already building resentment.